Tonight on NewsWatch, revenge for Osama. Two suicide bombers kill 80 people in Pakistan.
Plus, deliberate destruction. Will flooding force the government to destroy small towns to save larger ones?
And a daily fight. Christians in the Philippines struggle for their lives as Muslims try to force them from their homes. All this and more tonight on NewsWatch. The Taliban struck back today for the death of Osama bin Laden. Good evening, I'm Lee Webb.
And I'm Wendy Griffith. It is claiming responsibility for a deadly explosion at a military training facility in Pakistan. The blast killed at least 80 people and injured many more. Ephraim Graham reports in tonight's top story.
Emergency medical teams race to treat the more than 150 people injured in the morning explosion at a military training center in northwestern Pakistan. There are reports 800 recruits were boarding vans to leave a graduation celebration when two suicide bombers drove up on motorcycles and set off their bombs. The twin blasts killed more than 80. Most were paramilitary recruits. This man says, "I heard the blast, ran towards the spot to find out what happened, and suddenly the second blast took place."
There may be a desire on some Al-Qaeda members to exact revenge, and that's something that we have to be vigilant about, and we're monitoring all these situations.
The Somali wing of Al-Qaeda includes this American from Alabama, who also threatened the president this week.
"Today, we remind Obama and the rest of his cronies that they have entered the long war."
The Pakistani Taliban claims responsibility for this morning's attack, calling it revenge for the death of Osama bin Laden. Meanwhile, pro-Islamist lawyers protest America outside Pakistan's high court and attend special prayers for Osama bin Laden.
"Chief aim of this funeral is to convey the message to the USA as well as all other states which are against the Pakistan."
Ephraim Graham, CBN News.
The Secretary of Defense is promising extra protection for the families of the Navy team that killed Osama bin Laden. Al-Qaeda has threatened the men and their loved ones. The identities of the SEALs and other special forces are kept secret, but details of the Pakistan operation filtered out throughout the media. Joining us now is CBN News military correspondent Chuck Holton. And Chuck, how real is this threat against these special operators?
Well, it's very real, and this is the reason why they should have never let anybody know who it was that carried out this mission. Unfortunately, the vice president let it slip, as he's prone to do, and there you go. I certainly, if I was a Navy SEAL in Chesapeake, Virginia, I would not have my wife driving around with a Navy SEAL sticker on the back of her car. Right now, these days.
Are you familiar with any of the steps they are taking to protect them?
Well, that's probably one of the things they're doing, is they're just taking a very low profile.
Right,
they're
right.
Taking the stickers off their cars and, that sort of thing. I have heard that this place is now crawling with journalists, as you know, from all over the world, looking for because they want to know who it was that did the deed.
That actually shot Osama.
Right, and some of those journalists have been thrown out of restaurants and things here in town for asking too many questions about the Navy SEALs, yeah.
What's the best way then for the media and Americans in general to honor these men for the work that they've done without compromising their security?
You know, these guys don't want the recognition for having done what they see it, they're just doing their job. The best way we can honor them is to continue to support them in what they're doing over there, to give them the latitude to get the job done. This year in Afghanistan is a pivotal year. And either we're going to win it this year or we're going to lose it this year.
Do you think we need to get out?
I think right now it's a race to bankruptcy. We have broken the code on how to beat the Taliban, and that's to hit them in the pocketbook over and over again until they no longer have the funds to prosecute the war. But they are trying to do the same thing to us by making it so expensive that we can't afford to prosecute our side of it either. And they're doing a good job at that. We see right now it costs the U.S. military $400 a gallon for every gallon of fuel they have to bring into Afghanistan. That's every generator, every Jeep, every helicopter, everything, $400 a gallon. How long can we continue to do that? So it's a race to see who goes bankrupt first.
Yeah, it's real money that we have to spend in order to prosecute this war. Chuck, you've been to Afghanistan many times, visited with these soldiers, you've lived with them, you've gone to war with them. What is the death of Osama bin Laden? What is the effect on them and their morale?
I'm sure they high-fived and then went about their duty. Those guys understand that the death of Osama bin Laden changes almost nothing for them. They're not fighting al-Qaeda in Afghanistan. They're fighting the Taliban. And the Taliban and al-Qaeda are certainly united against us, but they're two totally different organizations. And what you're fighting in Afghanistan is a narco-insurgency. And these guys know that they still have a long road to go, and this fighting season is going to probably make the difference between winning and losing, and we need to give them all the support that, in order to allow them to win.
Right. Chuck, thanks for being with us. We appreciate it.
President Obama has wanted to close the prison at Guantanamo Bay for years. That's where America keeps prisoners in the war on terror. But many in Congress oppose any of the alternatives to closing Guantanamo. Now some senators are introducing a bill that would require the terrorist detention facility to be kept open. Senator Lindsey Graham says the idea Guantanamo may soon close is already causing a moral crisis in the war on terror.
We're forcing our nation to make inappropriate choices, killing people instead of capturing, losing intelligence, renditioning people to countries who are not going to have our interest at heart.
There are many terrorists still around the world that we could capture tomorrow, that we could gain valuable intelligence from, and we need to know where we will put them.
To me, keeping Guantanamo Bay open is a matter of common sense. The prison there has played and continues to play a critical role in keeping America safe.
Attorney General Eric Holder says the administration still plans to close Gitmo.
The floodwaters of the Mississippi River should reach New Orleans and Baton Rouge this weekend. The river could break the levees that protect those cities, so emergency authorities are considering extreme measures to prevent that. Dale Hurd reports.
In parts of Louisiana, they're fleeing what's coming. Even school kids are helping evacuate. But the enemy in Stephensville, Louisiana, is not just the floodwater from the Mississippi, but the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, who could decide to inundate their land by opening up something called the Morganza Spillway. That would submerge an area 100 miles long and flood the homes and businesses of some 2,500 people.
I know it's necessary that they do what they gotta do, but it's still, I guess in a way I am a little angry.
But the spillway looks to be bursting. And if the water here isn't released, levees along the Mississippi could burst, flooding New Orleans and Baton Rouge. And for those who could lose their homes and farms to save others, these are desperate hours.
That's what they're telling us. Take whatever you want out, because it probably will not be there when you come back.
Louisiana Governor Bobby Jindal is urging calm as residents try to save their homes and businesses.
I'm building a 19-foot levee all the way around my house. I don't have any flood insurance. You have to get flood insurance like 30 days ahead of time.
Backwater levees that way. And when the water comes in, we're going to possibly have 6 feet of water in our house.
And word that the Coast Guard reportedly may close down Mississippi to ships, shutting off traffic on one of the world's busiest waterways. Dale Hurd, CBN News.
Inflation climbed to its highest level in 2.5 years in April. Americans paid more for gas and food last month. The Consumer Price Index rose 0.4%. In the last 12 months, inflation rose more than 3%. The increase in gas prices accounted for half of last month's inflation. The cost of a gallon of gas is about $1.09 more than it was this time last year. Social Security and Medicare are running out of money even faster than expected. That's the findings of the latest report on the two massive social programs. Treasury Secretary Timothy Geithner says if Congress doesn't act soon, larger, more difficult adjustments will have to be made later. The report shows Medicare will be out of money by 2024 and Social Security by 2036. Almost 55 million retirees, disabled people, and children who have lost parents receive Social Security benefits. More than 46 million Americans are covered by Medicare.
Should the Constitution be amended to include a requirement for Congress to pass a balanced budget? That was the subject of a hearing on Capitol Hill. Republicans and Democrats are at odds trying to tackle the 2012 budget, deficit spending, and a $14 trillion federal debt. Some deficit hawks believe a constitutional amendment is the only way for Congress to get serious about spending reforms in the midst of major looming problems in the global and American economies.
If we fail to seize this opportunity, the result could well be a painful debt crisis that could begin not over the span of 6 months, but over the course of 6 hours on a Sunday evening while you sit with your family and investors in Asian markets begin to stampede away from American debt.
Opponents argue, though, that a constitutional amendment could cause problems when handling emergencies or funding a war.
And speaking of war funding, anti-war Republican Ron Paul officially entered the race for the White House. He announced he is seeking the nomination on Good Morning America. Paul first ran as a Libertarian back in 1988. 3 years ago, he unsuccessfully sought the Republican nomination. Paul is 75 years old. He believes America has caught up with his way of thinking.
Because time has come around to the point where the people are agreeing with much of what I've been saying for 30 years. So I think the time is ripe.
The former flight surgeon has represented Texas for more than 30 years. His long stand on cutting the size of government makes Paul popular with members of the Tea Party. Still, some of his stands are outside the mainstream. He thinks both prostitution and illicit drugs should be legalized. Also, former Arkansas Governor Mike Huckabee is expected to announce tomorrow if he will seek the Republican nomination.
Coming up, terrorism is much more than a threat to some Christians in the Philippines.
Do you take fish oil? There's an omega-3 supplement that's better than regular fish oil.
Staying healthy, it's not easy. I exercise regularly and eat lots of fruits and vegetables. I used to take a fish oil supplement too, but then I discovered something better than regular fish oil. Arctic Wonder Omega-3 Krill Oil. It's from the makers of One-A-Day, so I know I can trust it. The omega-3s in Arctic Wonder both support heart health and are scientifically proven to be better absorbed than regular fish oil. You'd have to take 6 of these fish oil soft gels to get the strength of just 2 Arctic Wonder soft gels.
The Arctic Wonder does not have an aftertaste.
They go down real easy.
Arctic Wonder isn't just good for your heart. It also supports healthy brain function and a healthy immune system.
This is one of the products that I plan to take for the rest of my life.
Arctic Wonder is from One-A-Day and not available in stores. For a special trial offer, call or go online now. Call 1-800-409-7339. That's 1-800-409-7339. Or go online to tryarcticwonder.com now.
If you have diabetes and you're on Medicare, call now for a new pain-free meter. These new meters are more accurate, they're easier to use, and the best news is you don't have to prick your fingers anymore. Call now, and Arriva Medical will send you one of these new meters for free. And if you have Medicare, your testing supplies may also be covered. Arriva makes it simple. They bill Medicare directly. There are no upfront costs. And they deliver your supplies right to your door for free. With these new meters, there's no coding. You don't have to prick your fingers. And some of these meters even talk.
Your blood glucose reading is 122.
And if you call 1-800-284-9762, we will send you a free Betty Crocker Diabetes Cookbook filled with delicious recipes.
Call Arriva today. You'd be glad you did.
You know, here in America, we refer to terrorist threats. But for people in many other countries, terrorism is a part of their everyday lives.
It really is, and that's the case for Christians in the southern Philippines. They're constantly targeted by radical Muslim rebels. Gary Lane was there.
Albert Francisco and his family have been forced to flee their home in southern Mindanao many times. Violent Muslim rebel groups have been waging war on the Christian population since he was 8 years old.
It was endless running. We had to evacuate because they burned our houses. We didn't want to get shot in the crossfire between the militant Muslims and the soldiers.
On one fateful day, armed men belonging to the Moro Islamic Liberation Front, or MILF, stopped Albert and his niece as they tried to escape. Stray bullets struck Albert in several places on his body.
I thought it was the end of my life. I was shot in the head and my legs. I heard one of the men say, "Make sure he's dead." I prayed to God, "Lord, please give me a second life. I will give my life to you."
Albert miraculously survived the gunshot wounds, but fragments are still embedded in his head and legs. An infection in his head and legs almost killed him, but emergency help from an international Christian group saved his life.
I prayed to God to help me in my situation. I didn't have the money to pay the hospital, and that's when a Christian worker came and his organization paid for my surgery and all my medical needs.
Jane Tankua was 6 months pregnant when she was shot in the chest in the midst of the fighting. She says timely assistance helped save her baby's life.
The heartbeat of my baby was very weak. I thank God for Brother Levi and the Christian group who helped us. I really felt God loves me.
Today, Jane and her husband are happy parents of a healthy baby boy. They're praying that the conflict will soon end so their son and his generation can live in peace in Mindanao. 12 Christian families are still living in this camp as refugees, more than a year and a half after their village was attacked by militant Muslims. These little children would love to go home, but they have no home to go home to. Brother Levi is a Christian worker to the Muslim areas. He asked us to hide his identity. He says for many years, Christians in Mindanao have suffered persecution at the hands of Muslim extremists.
They want to Islamize the whole world. Our church was burned 3 times, but still there. They think that they could defeat the Christian, but they could never defeat the Christians. There will be a great revival, so the Muslim could not do anything about it.
Christians like Albert and Jane testified this is true. They say their near-death experiences have drawn them closer to God.
I'm alive today, so I can tell those who don't believe in God to believe in Him, because He is real. He gave our lives. He knows what is best for us, and we should be happy to serve Him.
Gary Lane, CBN News, Mindanao, Philippines.
Up next, lifting up a legend. Billy Graham's neighbors talk about what the ailing evangelist means to their community.
Finding video on CBN.com just got easier. We've taken all our video, the 700 Club, news, testimonies, teachings, plus our 24/7 channels, and put them in one convenient location, CBN TV. Watch what you want, when you want. It's all simple to find, and now easier than ever to email a story to a friend. CBN TV on CBN.com.
Do you take fish oil? There's an omega-3 supplement that's better than regular fish oil.
Staying healthy, it's not easy. I exercise regularly and eat lots of fruits and vegetables. I used to take a fish oil supplement too, but then I discovered something better than regular fish oil.
Arctic Wonder Omega-3 Krill Oil. It's from the makers of One-A-Day, so I know I can trust it. The omega-3s in Arctic Wonder both support heart health and are scientifically proven to be better absorbed than regular fish oil.
Just one dose of Arctic Wonder Omega-3 Krill Oil has the strength of 3 times as much regular fish oil.
That means you'd have to take 6 of these fish oil soft gels to get the strength of just 2 Arctic Wonder soft gels, and it supports healthy cholesterol.
I take 2 caplets in the morning. They go down real easy.
My other fish oil were 6 capsules, and they were real big.
It's easy, easy, easy to swallow.
Now you can get a 1-month supply of Arctic Wonder during this special trial offer. To find out how, just call or go online now. Arctic Wonder is not available in stores. Arctic Wonder isn't just good for your heart. It also supports healthy brain function and a healthy immune system. Plus, Arctic Wonder is better absorbed than regular fish oil. You won't find Arctic Wonder in any store. But if you call or go online now, you can receive a special trial offer.
They say that if you have your health, you have everything. So why not do all you can to take care of yourself?
I take Arctic Wonder every day. Just 2 little soft gels give me the strength of 6 regular fish oil soft gels.
Arctic Wonder Omega-3 Krill Oil is better absorbed than regular fish oil and has no fishy aftertaste.
The Arctic Wonder does not have an aftertaste.
I was very happy with the fact I wasn't tasting it later.
I love my Arctic Wonder.
This is one of the products that I plan to take for the rest of my life.
Arctic Wonder is from One-A-Day, and it's not available in stores. For a special trial offer, call or go online now. Call 1-800-850-2235. That's 1-800-850-2235. Or go online to tryarcticwonder.com now.
A U.S. congressman wants to make international religious freedom a greater priority at the State Department. Jennifer Wishon reports.
For some reason, people aren't as interested in human rights and religious freedom as they used to be.
When Virginia Congressman Frank Wolf created the Office of International Religious Freedom in 1988, he says it was a dominant issue. Then President Ronald Reagan was an international force to be reckoned with, who considered the words of the U.S. Constitution to be a covenant with the rest of the world. But Wolf says concern for religious freedom has diminished.
In Iraq, where more biblical activities took place than any other country other than Israel, the Iraqi Christians are going through a very difficult time. They speak the same language as Jesus. Daniel was buried there. Babylon. Abraham is from Iraq. Esther is from Iraq. People just don't really focus, and now you're finding Iraqi Christians gunned down.
His legislation would, in part, require religious freedom training for all Foreign Service officers, strengthen the countries of particular concern designation process for nations that deny religious freedom, and elevate the International Religious Freedom Ambassador so he or she reports directly to the Secretary of State. New York City pastor Dr. Susan Johnson Cook has just been tapped by President Obama for the position, and she's walking onto a volatile world stage.
I mean, in Pakistan, they gunned down the only Christian member of the cabinet, Shahbaz Bhatti. They gunned him down. You have a Christian woman in Pakistan in jail for blasphemy, and yet we're just shoveling the money into Pakistan.
Dr. Susan Johnson Cook will identify countries that persecute people of faith, which will then be subject to U.S. sanctions. Congressman Wolf says religious freedom is an American issue.
When a country has human rights and religious freedom, they're generally a democratic country. They're generally a country that you're not at war with. You're not arguing with, you're not fighting with.
Looking ahead to 2012, Congressman Wolf intends to write a letter to every Republican candidate running for president, urging them to make human rights and religious freedom a top priority. Jennifer Wishon, CBN News, Washington.
A memorial service for Pastor David Wilkerson will be held Saturday in New York City. Wilkerson was the founder of Teen Challenge Ministries and the founding pastor of Times Square Church. He was laid to rest last week after being killed in a head-on collision in Texas. His wife, Gwen, was badly injured but has now been transferred from ICU to physical rehab, and she's expected to make a full recovery. Wilkerson's ministry took off in 1958 when he went to New York to reach out to gangs. The best-selling book, The Cross and the Switchblade, detailed his efforts to reach a young gang leader named Nicky Cruz.
I believe that they've touched many lives in the whole world. He was the first that crossed the line and went after the gangs and walking through the war zone. Either he knew that he was going to get killed, and Dave came and brought the message of Jesus Christ, and he left some famous words in this earth. The first one that God sent him from heaven to tell me, Nicky, Jesus loved you.
Great story. And you can see David Wilkerson's memorial service in its entirety live tomorrow at 2 p.m. Eastern Time at cbnnews.com.
Doctors say America's best-known evangelist is improving as he recovers from pneumonia. And as Heather Sells tells us, his hometown is rallying to support him.
There's still no word on when doctors at Asheville's Mission Hospital will release the Reverend Graham, but a spokeswoman said this morning that he's in fair condition and continues to improve.
When I heard that he was hospitalized, I thought, you know, you just never know with someone 92.
In Graham's hometown of Montreat, North Carolina, and around the country, there's been a groundswell of support during this latest bout of illness.
Billy Graham's a wonderful man. He's had a phenomenal ministry over the course of his lifetime. Some of his best friends and partners in ministry also live here in Montreat, and I know that the nation's thoughts and prayers are going out to Dr. Graham at this time.
Graham's only surviving sibling, 78-year-old Jean Ford, lives 2 hours away in Charlotte, North Carolina. She last visited with her brother 2 weeks ago and says she was encouraged.
I think he was the best that I've seen him in perhaps 5 years. He was laughing and joking and initiating conversation.
On Thursday, Graham resumed his routine, getting up for meals and enjoying Bible study with his pastor, sustained no doubt by the prayers of many. Heather Sells, CBN News.
Do you take fish oil? There's an omega-3 supplement that's better than regular fish oil.
Staying healthy, it's not easy. I exercise regularly and eat lots of fruits and vegetables. I used to take a fish oil supplement too, but then I discovered something better than regular fish oil.
Arctic Wonder Omega-3 Krill Oil. It's from the makers of One A Day, so I know I can trust it. The omega-3s in Arctic Wonder both support heart health and are scientifically proven to be better absorbed than regular fish oil.
Just one dose of Arctic Wonder Omega-3 Krill Oil has the strength of three times as much regular fish oil.
That means you'd have to take six of these fish oil soft gels to get the strength of just two Arctic Wonder soft gels, and it supports healthy cholesterol.
I take two caplets in the morning. They go down real easy.
My other fish oil were six capsules, and they were real big.
It's easy, easy, easy to swallow.
Now you can get a one-month supply of Arctic Wonder during this special trial offer. To find out how, just call or go online now. Arctic Wonder is not available in stores. Arctic Wonder isn't just good for your heart. It also supports healthy brain function and a healthy immune system. Plus, Arctic Wonder is better absorbed than regular fish oil. You won't find Arctic Wonder in any store, but if you call or go online now, you can receive a special trial offer.
They say that if you have your health, you have everything. So why not do all you can to take care of yourself?
I take Arctic Wonder every day. Just two little soft gels give me the strength of six regular fish oil soft gels.
Arctic Wonder Omega-3 Krill Oil is better absorbed than regular fish oil and has no fishy aftertaste.
The Arctic Wonder does not have an aftertaste.
I was very happy with the fact I wasn't tasting it later.
I love my Arctic Wonder.
This is one of the products that I plan to take for the rest of my life.
Arctic Wonder is from One A Day, and it's not available in stores. For a special trial offer, call or go online now. Call 1-800-850-2235. That's 1-800-850-2235. Or go online to tryarcticwonder.com now.
Well, you've been to cemeteries, no doubt, and know that gravestones are fairly simple, typically. A name, a date, a short phrase.
Yeah, but now one Seattle company is trying to bring gravestones into the 21st century. Quiring Monuments has created what they call the Living Headstone. A barcode is built into the stone. When people visit a headstone, they can scan the code with a smartphone. That will pull up a website allowing people to connect to their loved ones.
We can scan the barcode that quickly and then open the browser. And there is my dad's page. The ability to connect is going to make this whole experience not only more meaningful, but it's going to help people move through grief.
Well, if you're interested, the Living Headstone only cost about $150 more than a typical headstone.
That's really nice. Glad you're doing that.
That's amazing, you know?
Well, this technology has opened up so many vistas. We were at the Grand Canyon a couple of weeks ago, and they're using that kind of technology at various points around the canyon. You can just dial it up on your cell phone and learn more about it. It's pretty cool.
It's definitely the way of the future.
Yeah.
That's all for this edition of NewsWatch.
Thanks for joining us. Have a great weekend. We'll see you Monday.
Bye-bye.